Much for being here. Good to see you.
Great to see you. I'm honored to be with you.
Big day for women. Harvey Weinstein turns himself in. What's your reaction to that, and where do you see the Me Too movement going from here?
Well, it's a relief that somebody who was that flagrant and that inappropriate should finally be called to task. And I think the Me Too movement is just gathering strength. Right now, people have put up with too much for too long. And, you know, I know mothers and fathers who have seen their daughters hit on and taken advantage of, and they're sick of it. So men and women of character are both sick of it, and we're really glad to see that the mighty cannot simply buy off the other the people that they've offended and hurt.
Let's talk for a moment about the issue of education, which I know is your passionate issue. What is the single most important thing that needs to be done for California schools?
We absolutely must increase our investment in the schools of this state. When I graduated from high school, we were tied with New York at 5th of the 50 states, and the results were amazing. California was leading the world. The Silicon Valley is born here, not because of a confluence of rivers. We have no Tigris or Euphrates. Our Fertile Crescent was a fertile crescent of educational opportunity. Silicon Valley and Hollywood and so many other things that are amazing in California came out of our education. But we've dropped to 41st of the 50 states in per pupil spending. Mind you, we are the most expensive, prosperous state in the union, but now New York, which is still in the top 10, spends more than twice as much per child. So if you got a child in a California school, you really need to understand that local control funding formula, for all of its good qualities, is still the system is fundamentally underinvested in, and it's under-supported, and these kids need much more scaffolding.
What do you make of the fact that Antonio Villaraigosa is getting over $10 million from charter school advocates, and what do you think about charter schools?
Well, I think I actually think the idea was fine, but the fact is the bill was very poorly written. And so there's a bunch of charter schools that are either for-profit, cherry-picking the best and brightest kids, running, doing illegal things. In Livermore, they were charging Chinese kids $30,000 a family to send their kid to a Livermore school, $1,200 a month to live there, promising them they'd be admitted to Berkeley. I mean, in another school here in Los Angeles, they bought the principal a $34,000 convertible. Mm. So we need the kind of accountability. We need to follow the Open Meetings Act. We need to do so much more to make certain that the charters are absolutely held to the laws. And I've called for a moratorium until we've absolutely cleaned up this mess.
All right, we want to get to something called our policy issues. These are different issues that are out there. We want to pick one at random. I'm going to pick the issue of homelessness. What are you going to do differently than what's happening right now?
Well, first, you should know I did come and went on a Saturday night to Skid Row here in Los Angeles, and it was a heartbreaking experience. I will tell you, I have never seen so many elderly women. I have never seen so many women with little children on the streets. It's scandalous. So we're 12% of the nation's population, but 25% of the homeless. First day I'm in office, I'll declare a state of emergency as it relates to homelessness. We will absolutely put our shoulder to the wheel and do everything we can to create a lot more affordable, safe housing for people. It shouldn't just be that we now have a new facility open in Sacramento when you're dying, where you won't have to die on the street. Mm-hmm. It should be a lot more than that. And a lot of these people need mental health support and other support.
All right, let's have a little bit of fun. This is called the personal issues. This is where we got 30 seconds to learn a little bit more about you. So we try to get as many of these in as we can. Okay, you ready?
Okay,
ready to do this?
I'm ready.
All right, favorite Avenger?
Favorite Avenger? Well, it may be Wonder Woman.
Okay. Yeah. Early riser or night owl?
Night owl.
Favorite restaurant?
Biba's in Sacramento.
Best thing about
being a... Or Chez in Berkeley.
Oh, there you go. Best thing about being a Californian?
That we get to live here with this amazing weather and these wonderful people.
Best university in California?
Well, it's the University of California, Davis or Santa Barbara. I went to one for undergraduate and the other for graduate.
Favorite comedian?
Oh, favorite comedian. Well, for many years it was Lucille Ball. And I think right now, oh, it's hard for me to say. I'll just stick with the historic Lucille.
Everybody loves Lucy. Last question, how are you going to win this thing?
I'm going to win this because of my authenticity and the fact that I've gone from one end of the state to the other, from one side of the state to the other, talking to real people. I'm corporate free. I'm the one candidate who really is working with the people, for the future. So thank
Lainey
you so
said,
much.
Thanks for coming in. We appreciate it. Now, all of the leading candidates for California governor recently sat for in-depth interviews for our The Issue Is podcast, including Ms. Easton. You can stream that now.